of motion. Friends, previous timing, as we know, we have learned about Newton's first law of motion, but I would like to tell you in short once again that a body, it always remains in a separate or in a uniform motion unless any force is applied on it. If a body is in a rest, so on that timing it will remain in a rest, or if a body is in a motion, so on that timing it remains in a motion. So now let's start our Newton's second law of motion. So friends, what does the Newton's second law of motion say? Let's see. Newton's second law of motion says that force is directly proportional to rate of change in momentum. What is momentum? What is force? What is it directly proportional to? So let's see about it. Here actually I have given the formula also. Force is directly proportional to rate of change in momentum. Rate of change in momentum, that means the change in momentum upon time taken. Change in momentum, that means mva minus mu. We all know about the momentum, that what is the momentum, that's why I'm not telling you, because we have learned previous timing also about it. Change in momentum, mv, there are two momentum. What are the momentum? Mv, that means final momentum and initial momentum. So what is the change in momentum? Change in momentum, that means final momentum minus initial momentum, and rate of it, that is upon time taken. Friends, now this timing, let's see. Force is directly proportional to rate of change of momentum upon time taken. So now what happens, that here m is common, so we are keeping it as out from the bracket. So what happens here, that force directly proportional to m in whole the bracket p minus u remains here. Now what is the p minus u? As per me, you have learned a small formula, that is v minus u upon t. It is a formula of the acceleration. Do you know? Yes, Aksinath, do you know? Because in the 8th class also, there is a formula of the acceleration. So I hope that you are understanding to me. So here, leaving to v minus u upon t, we can write here acceleration, that means a. So here, directly force is directly proportional to mass into acceleration. Now, after finding many more things, it had been known this thing, that the proportional sign is above the k. Proportional, that is equals to k. And k is equals to 1. And we all know this thing, that if we are multiplying any number, any algebraic identity with the 1, so on that timing it will remain same. If we are multiplying 1 into x, so we are getting x. If we are multiplying 1 into 2, so we are getting 2. If we are multiplying 1 into a into b, so always we are getting ab. So same here, when we multiply to 1 into m into a, so we got directly a formula, that is force is equal to mass into acceleration. Force is denoted by friends F, mass is denoted by M, and acceleration is denoted by A. So I hope that you understood the second law of motion, and next Friday we will learn about Newton's third law of motion, that means Newton Baba's third law of motion, what does it say. So I want to tell you these things. Thank you.